I feel real confident in the three people that I chose for the Supreme Court.
And here they are, Edward Mansfield, an appellate judge from Des Moines, Bruce Zager, a district court judge from Waterloo, and Thomas Waterman, an attorney from Davenport. The long high court battle finally over.
Todd Magel is here now to show us what it all means.
Well, it's been 2 years since the Supreme Court first voted on the same-sex marriage law, 3 months since those three justices were voted off the bench, and it's taken 2 months to find their replacements. It's an historic process that's never happened before.
I got a call from the governor about 12:30 in the afternoon, and I was having lunch, and was very excited to be interrupted from lunch.
Meet one of Iowa's new Supreme Court judges, 54-year-old Edward Mansfield, currently a judge on the Iowa Court of Appeals.
I'm very, very grateful to be chosen to have this opportunity to serve the state.
Mansfield, Thomas Waterman, and Bruce Zager are the replacement judges. Governor Branstad chose them from a field of 9 nominees.
I just felt they were all very good and very capable, and my judgment was that these were the best three.
Attorney Guy Cook helped narrow the field of 60 potential Supreme Court judges during the most open nomination process in state history, broadcast live on the Internet. He says the governor's choices make sense.
It represents a diversity not only of experience but perspective. The governor picked a lawyer from Eastern Iowa with a great reputation and experience. He picked a judge, a district court judge from Waterloo, and he picked an appellate judge with great credentials and experience.
Like it or not, during the past 2 years, the judicial selection process for the Iowa Supreme Court has become a political event. The question now is, will the political scrutiny continue?
We and probably 500 plus thousand Iowans will be watching them.
Chuck Hurley speaks for the Iowa Family Leader, the Christian group headed by Bob Vanderplas that urged voters to oust three Supreme Court judges up for retention in November.
We don't want any more retention fights if we don't have to have them. And so these three, if they remain in their constitutional role, will probably be retained.
On the other side, the group Justice Not Politics hopes the new judges and their open selection process will help to calm down the controversy.
I think because of that openness and transparency that there's some confidence in the way that we select judges here in the state.
Now keep in mind, the new Supreme Court judges are also on probation, so Kevin, they will also face a retention vote a year from now.
The female candidate that was among the finalists, or among those forwarded to the governor, Angela Willig, not chosen. Has there been any reaction to that?
A lot of disappointment from a lot of the people we talked to. She was the only female, but Chuck Hurley says that he's happy because she actually supported the gay rights vote. So all men now on the Iowa Supreme
Court. All men, all white Supreme Court. All right, Todd, thank you very much.